Hello and welcome everyone to Let's Play Tomb Raider 2 Remastered. This is guys 115 speaking. Ha! The Dagger of Xi'an is ours. But there's a problem. Of course there is. We haven't seen the last of these guys, have we? So let me welcome you to Home Sweet Home. In this level, such a cool epilogue to the best Tomb Raider game out there in my opinion. There are no secrets to worry about, however there are a plethora of goodies, 45 goodies concentrated in such a short level, and the moment we unlock this door you'll soon see why, and we are gonna kill all 16 enemies. That is in fact the victory condition for this level. You need to slay the 16th and final enemy for the exit to trigger, okay? We are also gonna focus on unlocking all 4 achievements pertaining to, well, not this level, but our first playthrough. So let me explain. We are tasked with finishing off all of Bartoli's henchmen invading Lara's home in her ballroom whilst the music is on, according to the Let's Dance achievement description. And honestly, that's not entirely true. The music will eventually stop playing, but you can keep killing and the achievement will still unlock, thankfully. So it's not like it's a strict time limit, you need to do it before the music stops playing, right? This achievement, I'll be honest, I'm very disappointed it's not called Ballroom Blitz. It would have been perfect, but we can't have everything, right? Now, unfortunately, this achievement is mutually exclusive with I Really Think I've Seen Enough achievement, which tasks us with killing the final enemy in Lara's bathroom, right? So what this essentially means is that today I'm going to show you two playthroughs through the Home Sweet Home level. First, we're going to focus on Let's Dance achievement, and naturally, we're also going to unlock an achievement for just beating this level. And then I'm going to 100% this level properly with a little bit of a surprise and unlock the remaining two achievements, okay? So you can look forward to two playthroughs. Furthermore, we have a gun cupboard key and the Dagger of Xi'an in our inventory. How awesome is that? Not just that, but Lara actually has the Dagger of Xi'an behind her belt somehow. I was trying to trigger the photo mode, thank you. There we go. So she wields it, but she's not about to use it to stab Bartoli's henchmen and turn them all into dragons or anything like that. Instead, she's gonna use a far more conventional weaponry whilst wearing her absolutely amazing pajamas. Let's see what's inside. And we need to be quick and not make a single pointless move if we're gonna get our hands on these supplies before the henchmen will arrive, because we can't fight them here. We need to go to the ballroom, okay? So just follow the moves I'm doing. This, I think, is really the most efficient way of picking them up. Well, that I've been able to find out anyway. We'll need all the ammo we can get, and I already hear some groans of the baton-wielding thugs. Okay, we need to get out of here. These guys will try to block our way. Oh no, Lara. Don't let the bed be your worst enemy, pretty please. Let's jump over the railing. What's the worst that can happen, right? Whoa! Oh no, Lara, you're clumsy. Okay, we're avoiding bullets like crazy. We need to immediately play the music. It is the only way. There's the button. We can see it even through the darkness, thanks to the chandeliers. Oh my god. I wish it prioritized these hit points, but oh well. And another one bites the dust. What? Okay, okay. Can we just calm down for a second, everyone? Pretty please? You'll all get your turn, I promise. Couple of things whilst the wonderful Venice violins are playing. We need to summon an additional enemy via entering the kitchen and letting him force the door open from the outside. This will trigger a baton-wielding thug. And I see a dog running our way as well, my goodness. Don't let the dogs bite you. The damage they deal is absolutely massive, okay? Now, before another heap for slaughter will come, let us actually step outside next to the assault calls and summon yet more enemies from the outside. There should be a sniper or a hitman with a dog accompanying him and a baton-wielding henchman. Well, I see them. Oh yeah, there they are, approaching from the darkness. Preferably, we don't want to just charge them like a bull. Alright, we want to lure them back into the ballroom, of course. I'm just not that confident in the pathfinding. Let's see. Okay, there's the dog, there's the sniper. You know what, guys? It seems like you got this. So back into the ballroom. You got this, girl. Oof. Now that was a close call. But we don't care about the number of medkits we use as long as we unlock Let's Dance. Alrighty then. Let's check our kills count. We are at 10, that means there are 6 more enemies we need to take care of. Now, the enemies we are looking for are in fact outside of Lara's main entrance, outside, surrounded by the Fiamma Nera trucks, okay? And you know what? I'd really love to take a picture of these. Just because of the added detail. I don't know why, I find this incredibly cool. Let's also capture the fish fountain in the distance and roll it just a little. And do not worry about stepping outside of the ballroom or the music stopping to play. This will not invalidate the achievement as long as you triggered the music at least once and every enemy will die in the ballroom, okay? Now, stepping outside, oh yeah, there they are, essentially triggers them. So it's tricky because some enemies only appear after you land a certain number of kills, and some will need to be pulled from certain areas like this, but that's why I'm showing you everything, okay? Now, the snipers have sometimes trouble getting to the ballroom, as you can see. They're not the brightest ones, which means you need to lure them out whilst they have the opportunity to land hits on you. Whoa! How did it survive the shotgun blast? Okay, I hear the footsteps, they are very close. My god, they're not very bright. Can they make it now? Please, guys, it's really easy, just move forward. Oh, 3 of them. Well, what a surprise. Okay, and we are at 15, that means the final enemy, a boss, will appear, and we'll need to take care of him, and this should be a familiar returning friend. Usually he appears from the kitchen side, but it really could be anywhere, maybe even in the pool area. Now, do not press the button again, it might invalidate the achievement, and let's not mess around with that. Thank you for stepping under the chandelier, that's what I've been hoping for, because I want to take a picture of you. Guys, if this henchman looks familiar, that's because he is familiar. This is the guy we encountered back in Opera House, guarding Marco Bartoli's seaplane. These guys are here just out for revenge. And potentially also getting the dagger of Xi'an, and this guy would probably stab his heart and become the next Chinese dragon emperor or something like that. Yeah, make of that what you will, whatever their motivation is, they're here for the dagger and for revenge. What I really love is the fact that his arm is bandaged as a reminder of the previous encounter with Lara. And there are his massive colts, which I think would break any ordinary person's arm, just wielding them in two hands, let alone in one hand, but there you have it. What I wanna do is I wanna capture the chandelier in this somehow, and him as well, and the corpses. This will be a great shot, I think. So anyway, this is what he looked like in the original. The red eyes have always been there, however, there's now the Temple of Xi'an marking that they added, a piece of a ceremonial robe that Bartoli's elite henchmen in the Dragon's Lair and Floating Isles used to wear, right? Question is, where the hell was this guy? But it's really easy to just run around and shoot him in the back, to be honest. There we go, this is the entire boss fight. And let's see if Let's Dance is unlocked. Yes! Awesome! We did it, guys! Now, before we transition to the final cutscene of the level, I would like to actually stop here and restart the level, okay? We've been just after the Let's Dance achievement, nothing else, and all the corpses of all 16 enemies are now concentrated in the ballroom, okay? So it's okay to just turn on the music once, see, the button is in this turned on position, that's one condition, and then just slaughter all enemies within the boundaries of the ballroom. You can go as far as the very edge of the entranceway to other rooms, be it these corridors, or be it the kitchen, okay? It all still counts, so it's fairly generous in that regard. It can just be tricky, because you also need to leave the ballroom and pull them from the kitchen door area, and also the entrance with the trucks, and that's all there is to it. Guys, I'm gonna see you back at the beginning of this level, and we're gonna 100% it. We are gonna get our hands on all goodies, unlocking souvenirs from across the globe. We are gonna kill the final boss, Colt, in Lara's bathroom, ensuring that he's part of the final cutscene. And also, we are just gonna land the achievement for beating the level at all. We didn't this time because I stopped it just in time. It will feel way more rewarding in that way, okay? So, I'm gonna see you here just in a second. Okay, now's our chance to properly 100% the level. That means also all pickups, not just all kills, and also all breakable objects. There are 12 windows, I believe, we can break with our shotgun, which is a lot of fun. Make sure to skip this cutscene, we'll make it easier to control Lara. You can even control her during the shot of Bartoli's henchmen outside, but of course you can't really see where you're going, and that makes it trickier, okay? Do we have any... No, we don't have any starting flares or anything like that. Everything is in the cupboard. Lara only goes to bed with the dagger of Xian. Honestly, I'd be terrified to do that. I would think it whispers something to me, but she's a braver woman than I ever will be. So, let's just get our hands on all these. Whoa. How did a dog make it here already? My goodness. But it's so incredibly liberating to be able to take care of these hoodlums without having to go to the ballroom first. Oh, can you shut it, you mutt? Pretty please. Thank you. Usually, when that doesn't work, violence does. And when violence doesn't work, greater violence does, apparently. That's something I guess Tomb Raiders teach us. Okie dokie, so let's take a look at our balcony. Will there be a henchman? But this also showcases quite nicely how we can break all the windows. Okay, there you are. Some goddamn peace and quiet, finally. Oh, let's break the remaining ones. Ah, four windows in one blast. That is so satisfying. By the way, in case you're wondering, the two windows in the bathroom, not breakable, okay? Still, fun fact, you can grab the ledge here from the assault course, even in Lara's home level, and climb up into her bathroom. Just thought like pointing it out, okay? Doesn't really work the other way. No, we can also not destroy them from this side. I tried, trust me. Anyway, Lara's bathroom is gonna play a pivotal role for an achievement later on in this level. But for now... Okay, two more pickups remaining. Perfect. We picked up the shotgun shells of the sniper on the balcony. By the way, there are only two enemies out of 16 that drop something, and one is the hitman over here on this balcony who drops shotgun shells. Later on, there's gonna be another hitman that will drop a small med pack, okay? And that's it. Everything else is in the cupboard, and at the end of the assault course, you'll be able to find a box of shotgun shells. Talking about the assault course, I have an ambition to actually beat the assault course in Home Sweet Home level. We'll see how we'll do in that regard. It might be potentially a disastrous idea, but come on, I just want to have fun, okay? Oh, and one thing I want to show you also is you can pretty much access any room in Lara's home in the Home Sweet Home level. Let's turn on the music. Oh, come on. Let a girl have some peace and quiet. Okay. Now, will you let us frolic around in our own mansion, pretty please? What I wanted to show you is the pool area, but at night. I don't know why, I just thought it's incredibly cool to show you this. Because it really is a great feeling to remember the first time we took a dip here in Tomb Raider 1 Remastered, or heck, even the current playthrough when I showed you Lara's home in Tomb Raider 2 Remastered, right? And now, the journey pretty much ends where it feels it really began. And you can see the moonlight shining from the roof up there. In the original, this was not the case. It looked identical to daytime, right? Which was a bit of an oversight, of course. But here, it's just absolutely glorious. I love that. So, we have more windows to break. By the way, these kinds of windows, the ones over here, they're not dynamic objects. They're not breakable, right? They look very sturdy and solid. They honestly look like something out of Hogwarts, interestingly enough. I'm getting into Christmas mood already. Okay, so, just like before, let's lure this henchman in. And by the way, if before luring him in, you break these windows, he'll use them to climb into the kitchen, which I think is really funny. Okay, if you aim at the middle, You can usually get two windows for the price of one buckshot, but nothing's gonna be as cool as getting four of them. Oh, bummer. And you know what? Let's leave the freezer alone. We don't want to disturb Winston, who's probably hiding there right now, do we? Okay, so, stepping outside into the assault course area, we should find a dog and a lone hitman, okay? And I can hear footsteps for a hoodlum already, a baton wielder. There they are. Let's take cover somewhere so we're not out in the open to be shot at, for example here. Okay, perfect. Oh, sneaky dog. Oh my god, where's that dog? This is terrifying. Where is it? Oh my god, I'm absolutely mortified. Where are you? Ah, you annoying beast. Okay, okay, this was probably not the best idea. I had no idea this would happen. Let's just get on the concrete road, okay? Surely it's gonna find us. Or not. Oh my goodness. I've never had this happen before. I feels like I say that every single time, don't I? Well, you know what? We can just ignore the dog and get onto the assault course in the meantime. Okay? So I want to ensure that we do it. And I'm very curious, via the timer on screen, if we'll actually beat our original Lara's home time. Probably not, but we'll see. Because I'm under a lot of stress and duress with that bloody dog. Whoa! Pretty good, Lara. But I really want to know what kind of time we'll have. And unfortunately, the game doesn't really show you the timer in Home Sweet Home level, okay? Which, I mean, come on, guys. Surely more of us completed the assault course whilst being assaulted by Bartoli's henchmen. Right? Yeah, probably not. But it's something I just always wanted to do. So here we are. And yeah, you can absolutely jump and climb in through those windows into Lara's bathroom if you're so inclined for whatever reason. Okay. Seriously, a moonlit assault course. That's wonderful, isn't it? And a swan dive. Wonderful, Lara. And you know what? Just to keep things different, I always take the left side. Let's take the right side this time. There's the dog. Oh, I've seen him. I see him. Well, you're not gonna get your snack up until we use the zipline, and then, actually, I'm a bit worried about what happens later, but, I would also very much like to finish this level without using even a small med pack, but, that would require me not to do stupid things like this. Yeah, you hungry. I get it. Bloody beast. And there's our time. Did we do better or worse than in Lara's home? Huh. You guys know. I don't yet. Future Zelgadis does. Oh, there's a sniper. Oh, 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 and a dog. If the dog bites us, though, it's all over. Oh, thank god. Okay, so like I said, first sniper on the balcony dropped shotgun shells. This one dropped a small med pack, and they're coming out of the garden over here, which, my friends, contains the final pickup of the game. So let's get that Souvenirs Across the Globe achievement, pretty please. Drumroll. There we go. Take every collectible item in a single walkthrough. My goodness, this feels rewarding. But we're not done yet. Outside of the main entrance to Lara's home, there are parked trucks and more hoodlums. There should be two more hitmen and a dog, okay? So let's lure them in like this. There's the dog approaching. And of course, let's try not get bitten. The damage these dogs deal is absolutely massive, okay? Not when they're dead, though. Okay, and one more should be the 15th kill, summoning the final boss. Let's see it. Yes, yes, okay, awesome. So now all we gotta do... Oh no, he's here? Oh! Okay, okay, okay. This guy's pathfinding is actually really good. Unlike the snipers, he will not get stuck, which is good for the purpose of the achievement we wanna unlock, and that's, I really think I've seen enough. Where he needs to be part of the final cutscene. Okay, let's make it into Lara's bathroom, through her bedroom. And the best way I found of doing this, really, is hiding in the shower corner here, okay? And this, my friends, is where I'm gonna make sort of a level end save for this run, okay? we need to allow ourselves a bit of a grace period. Oh, by the way, cool thing. We can now see China departed and UK arrival stamps in Lara's passport. So after the explosion in the Great Wall of China, it seems Lara just summoned her helicopter again to get out of here before Chinese authorities would come pick her up and essentially send her into a prison camp for blowing up part of their cultural heritage. It'd be difficult to explain. I killed the dragon and that's what caused this. Yeah, I'm sure they would believe that story. So she got a lovely stamp, a UK arrival with a Big Ben icon there. That's pretty awesome. We are also going to see all these stamps in the Golden Mask expansion, plus a new one for the new location where she's going to appear. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's ensure Colt dies in Lara's shower or its vicinity. Yes, my friends, we did it!
Don't you think you've seen enough?
And with that shotgun blast still ringing in our ear, well deserved by the way, we realize we really have seen enough and unlocked the final achievement of this playthrough. So there we go. Now unfortunately we do not get to see the final stat screen just of the Home Sweet Home level, and this was also the case in the original Tomb Raider 2. You are thrown straight into the credits and then the final stat screen for the entire game. However, not for the Home Sweet Home level, and this is a bummer, and I was actually hoping that the remasters would remedy that so that you would see both. First the Home Sweet Home level stat screen, then maybe the credits, then the final statistics, but there you have it. I mean, ultimately in the larger picture, it doesn't matter. What matters are the final statistics. We have taken 8 hours 17 minutes, so quite a long way away from the I only play for sports still 6-hour requirement, but that's because I stop, talk and take in the sights. Now this shouldn't also count the time I spent talking in the photo mode. This is just me talking outside of the photo mode. So it's really funny to think about that just my commentary added a few extra hours to the entire playthrough. When I finished the game run on my GOG version, it took 6 hours and 19 minutes, right? Because there I do no talking whatsoever, but I still practice a few things. Now, we have found all 48 secrets. There is no reward for finding all the secrets, outside of course the individual codex of achievements and getting the goodies in-game, which in turn helps you get all the pickups and the souvenir from around the globe achievement, which we got in this level. Now, as it pertains to the pickups, this is really interesting, because actually, the total number of pickups does account for the one invisible pickup in Opera House that doesn't actually exist, so it should really say 584 pickups. But remember, the Dagger of Xi'an in the Dragon's Lair then doesn't count into the total pickups, so that balances each other. I would subtract the invisible pickup in Opera House for getting all the secrets, and I would add the Dagger of Xi'an in the Dragon's Lair as a pickup, so I would ultimately end up with the exact same number that we see here. Very important caveat, In the remastered version of Tomb Raider 2, you get 5 extra goodies in the Barkang Monastery level. There are 5 additional supplies that Bartoli's henchmen drop that they did not in the original. Whether this is a bug fix in the remasters and they were supposed to, or if Aspyr and Saber have just decided to give us 5 new goodies specifically in that level, I guess we will never know. But just keep in mind that when you'll be running your own playthrough, let's say in the original version of the game, there'll be a discrepancy. Although, you will not even see pickups on the final stats or the level end screens. It's annoying, but the original Tomb Raider 2 wouldn't show you the pickups. This is something they remedied and sort of standardized for all 3 games in the remasters, which I really appreciate. Now, when it comes to the kills, we killed all 516 enemies. It is absolutely awesome. No differences here between the original or the remasters. And when it comes to the ammo used versus the ammo we hit with, well, in Tomb Raider 1, our percentage of our accuracy was 80%. In Tomb Raider 2, amazingly, it's 89%. I think that has something to do with the fact we used M16, which is literally the most precise weapon in the game, and we used less of Uzis, which is the most imprecise weapon in the game, right? So I think that's what accounts for the increase in accuracy. And a point I'm really proud of, this was never intended to be a Nomad's Run or anything like that, yet throughout the course of the entire Tomb Raider 2, when killing all the enemies and getting all the goodies, we only used the equivalent of 2 large med packs. I believe this was 2 small health packs and 1 large one. The large one we used in Barkang Monastery. As for the small ones, I remember using 1 small one in Venice, and well, that's about it. I actually have no recollection where we used another one. Maybe you guys will remember and can let me know. And yeah, finally, as for the distance traveled, it's 49.58 kilometers. Now, this doesn't really mean anything in a virtual world, right? Because essentially, it's a world comprised of squares. However, just as an interesting comparison, this converts to roughly 26,800 squares in game. And in Tomb Raider 1 Remaster, just for comparison, we traveled roughly 37 kilometers and traveled almost 21,000 squares. So essentially, it's like there's an additional quarter of the Tomb Raider 1's size added on top in Tomb Raider 2. That's how big the game is. It's a very extremely rough estimate of what a game size could mean, but I just thought pointing it out is very interesting. And finally, a stat that I've decided to track throughout the entirety of the game, even though there's no reason or point to or any overarching achievement for, and that's the breakables. Be it the counterweights dropping on top of us in Opera House, or the icicles in Tibet, or just shooting through windows in Italy or in offshore rig, these are all breakable objects, and also of course breakaway tiles, and we have broken all 174 of them, which feels kind of awesome to finally see what the number of breakable objects in Tomb Raider 2 is. I feel like I've sort of redeemed myself from a past sin, in a sense. So guys, I hope you had an absolute blast. Normally we would go to sort of end the video and I would thank my amazing patrons, but I have some additional information prepared for you, because if you beat the Tomb Raider 2 Remastered for the first time, you essentially unlock 2 exciting features, and I'm gonna talk about them in the main menu, where I'm gonna see you in a second. Okay, let's just pretend this took a second and we are back in the main menu. So probably the most exciting feature that you will unlock by beating the core game is the outfit selector. Now the cool thing is, it doesn't really matter if you use the new game, New Game Plus, or you boot up the Golden Mask expansion, whichever one you do, the outfit selector will be available. Not only that, you can go to any of your previous levels, let's go as far as the end of the very first level in our playthrough, the Great Wall of China, and when you open up the menu and scroll to Lara's shades, it will now say outfit. And you can scroll across all the outfits in all 3 Tomb Raider games. Even though, let's say, you haven't yet beaten Tomb Raider 3, you will have access to its outfits, and you will have a separate toggle for sunglasses on and off. Okay, let me show you what that looks like. And there we go, Lara is ready to kick some Bartoli's ass. Another cool thing is that this carries over into the in-game cutscenes, right? This is awesome. Okay, I just thought it's funny to show you this.
Your way of trying the doors for me.
Yeah, this guy thinks it's funny as well. So another cool thing is, it carries over into next level, so you don't have to do it each time you start a new level, it will carry over. The sunglasses and the outfit, both irrespective of what outfit you choose, you can mix and match with the sunglasses, which I think is absolutely awesome. Now, one thing I'd really like to try as well, what happens if Lara changes her outfit in middle of a cutscene, right? So let's get her into the Vegas with sunglasses again, and let's just observe what will happen. I'm very curious.
You are not one of them. Then the occultist Gianni B acquired it.
So despite the fact she's wearing high heels, she'll still throw a boot at this guy. I mean, I expected this would happen, but I just find it funny. But let's see what Lara will actually look like once she's ready.
We reach for our weapons once more.
The true detox of...
Ah, so the outfit change is forced in the cutscene, but the sunglasses toggle option is remembered by the game. I find this fascinating. Okay, this is interesting, and will we start the next level wearing Vega's outfit? Or... Ah, no, so in these cases the change will be forced upon you, but the sunglasses are completely a separate thing, okay? So I think this was a really interesting experiment, and you can fool around with this pretty much whenever, despite the fact that you have not yet beaten New Game Plus or the Golden Mask expansion, you will have full access to the outfit selector in both of these game modes, even in the expansion levels you haven't played yet. Just by beating Tomb Raider 2, you unlock it for levels you have not yet beaten, which I think having extra options is always very nice. Now, there is one disadvantage to this being implemented in, I think, the third major patch, and that's that before, whenever on loading screen you would hold the look and the walk key, Lara would get her sunglasses. And this didn't require you to beat the game in advance, okay? So unfortunately now you do have to beat the game at least once before you are able to use Lara's sunglasses. That's the only disadvantage this has, but I think the benefits outweigh the costs given how easy it is to use this. By the way, the look key and the walk key cheat has not been removed. Let me show you. If you now start holding the look and then the walk key and then come from Lara's home, you can even skip the FMV and we're still holding them on the loading screen. Lara will not have her sunglasses on. Instead, you will see a really cool Easter egg in the main hall of her manor.
Let's do some tumbling. The main hall.
There we go. And there's the T-Rex painting instead of the original one, okay? So the look and the walk key cheat still works in game, doesn't disable any achievements or anything like that. The confirmation that it works is that the painting here in Lara's home will be replaced by this lovely achievement icon for not killing the T-Rex. Okay, just thought like pointing it out. Now, if you go to Tomb Raider 3's Lara home and use the look key and the walk key cheat, you will find something incredibly cool when you leave the manor. But I'm gonna talk about that once we reach Tomb Raider 3, okay? One point that I also wanted to show you that I think is worth showing is that the outfit selector only applies to the games you've beaten, meaning if you go to Tomb Raider 3 and you haven't beaten it yet, you will find it in the in-game menu, but you cannot use it. Again, it will say, just like it did in Tomb Raider 2 before we've beaten it, feature available upon completing the game once, okay? So, in my particular case, at the time of me recording this, in Steam version of the game, I've beaten Tomb Raider 1 Remastered and Tomb Raider 2 Remastered, but not Tomb Raider 3, so the outfit selector is not available. And even if we go back into, let's say, the main menu, and I'll start the new game holding the look and the walk key. Okay, look, walk, and now I confirm. Now I skip the FMV, just like we did Lara's home. Lara's sunglasses are not on, okay? So this feature has been disabled with the introduction of the outfit selector. So the only disadvantage is that you cannot play the game for the first time, or what the game thinks it's the first time after installation, with the sunglasses until you beat it, okay? So just wanted to talk about that, but back to the main menu, because there's another feature I literally just quickly skipped over, and that's the New Game Plus. Via beating each core game in its normal difficulty, saying New Game, you will unlock the so-called New Game Plus. Let's just take a really quick dip into it. It is functionally the same thing, okay? However, Lara will automatically start with her sunglasses on, because this is now more badass Lara for a more badass version of the game. What makes New Game Plus special? You know what, let me show that to you in practice. First of all, we start with all the weapons in our inventory and some very humble amounts of ammunition. However, there are a few tweaks done here. First of all, I'm gonna light up a flare and essentially show you that these things now last for a very, very short time indeed. Let's take a quick dip into the water. And they essentially last for, I think, 20 seconds or something along those lines, whereas before, I think they lasted even well over a minute. Oh, it's already flickering. That is not a good thing. Okay. There we go. Oh, it didn't even flicker properly to give us a hint that it's dying. It just went out. Well, that's a bit disappointing. But yeah, so the flares last for a shorter duration, which I guess makes the game more difficult, but you can always light up your environments with pistols. But let me show you another thing. That's just how tougher the enemies got. The damage we now receive is absolutely massive, and the damage the enemies receive is reduced, as opposed to the original game. Okay, so it seems like it's roughly double the amount of health for this tiger and double the amount of damage he deals to Lara, but it's not always this clear cut. There are some enemies who have triple the amount of health and deal triple the amount of damage. Every single enemy in the New Game Plus difficulty mode received a unique touch-up. And one cool thing I want to talk about is that every single level in the New Game Plus difficulty will have a plus sign in its name. This essentially leads me to believe that every New Game Plus difficulty level is actually a separate level file and a separate map from that of a normal difficulty. It's called differently, and also, there are no med packs to be found anywhere in these levels. Instead, you will only get med packs as a reward for finding each level's three secrets, okay? So like the stone dragon over here. This is the only way to get med packs, and it kind of encourages sort of a completionist playthrough through the New Game Plus difficulty, which is exactly what I'm gonna do with a separate video. You are gonna find a bit more ammunition as a result, although not that much, and given how enemies have double or triple the amount of health, ammunition is a much bigger concern on this difficulty, okay? So be on the lookout for me releasing one long play video where I'll 100% the entire game on this difficulty with no commentary whatsoever, just for immersion and atmosphere, okay? I'll tackle it in the same way I did for Tomb Raider 1 Remastered. Okay, and now I'm gonna see you back in the main menu yet again, because I'd like to talk about our achievement plan status. Hey guys, back at the main menu for the final time this time. I just briefly wanted to take us back to what I talked about in my Lara's Home video for Tomb Raider 2 Remastered, and that's the proposed achievement plan, okay? So overall, the entirety of Tomb Raider 2 has 89 achievements. That's because 23 pertain to the Golden Mask expansion and 66 to the core Tomb Raider 2, right? I'm gonna tackle the Golden Mask expansion via a separate playlist once we're fully done with Tomb Raider 2 Remastered. However, for the 66 achievements in the core game, I proposed 3 playthroughs. And it's a plan that worked out really great in Tomb Raider 1, and I had no reason to believe it would be any different here, and, you know, after just beating the first playthrough, I think we're on the right track to make this fun 3 playthroughs. So, for the first playthrough, I suggested getting rid of all 62 level-specific achievements plus souvenirs from across the globe, just an achievement for getting all the pickups, because this is something I would have done anyway. I just like to 100% my games, right? So we have completed the first playthrough with overall 63 achievements. There are 3 more achievements to go. Now, again, you can combine them into one playthrough, but like I said before, I'd rather have 3 fun playthroughs than 1 fun playthrough and 1 miserable playthrough, okay? So what I'm going to do next, and it's going to be the next video I'm going to work on, and it's going to take me some time. I'm going to need 1 or 2 weeks maybe to fully finish it, because there is a lot of practice and editing involved. That's because the video will cover the entire game, but trying to beat it with pistols only and under 6 hours. I had an absolute blast doing this for Tomb Raider 1. Feel free to check out that video in case you're interested. For Tomb Raider 2, I already managed to do this on my PlayStation 4 when working for my Platinum Trophy, and I managed to pull it off in 2 hours and 37 minutes. As you can now see on screen, sorry for the bad quality, still haven't figured out how to really capture screens from consoles. Sorry about that. PC Master Race guy here. Okay, so what I'm gonna try and do is beat this time and aim closer and closer to that 2.5 hours mark. We'll see how successful I'll be. I'll still need to practice on PS5, on GOG, and then finally do my recordings on Steam. But it's gonna be an absolute blast, and it's gonna be a video where I'm gonna do some seldom commentary here and there, but most of it is gonna be quiet. I feel like I've offered all the commentary I can and want to for each level of this game, and this is gonna be a video where if I'm gonna comment, it's just gonna be to accompany some of the visual aid on screen on how to set certain things up and to explain why I'm tackling certain things, okay? So you have that video to look forward to, and it will essentially help you to unlock it. And full disclaimer, and I'm gonna put this disclaimer also at the beginning of that video, I'm not a speedrunner, I don't have the skills nor the ambition. It's gonna be more of a casual guide on how to unlock both achievements. I'm gonna use some speedrunning tricks that I've managed to reproduce, but I am far from being a speedrunner, and calling myself such would be, I think, disrespect to some amazing speedrunners in Tomb Raider community. Instead, I'm a dirty casual when it comes to speedrunning, so I'm gonna call it more of a time trial video, and hopefully that's actually gonna make it more useful to you guys, who I assume vast majority of you are also not speedrunners. So it's gonna be an easy, approachable way to beat the game under 6 hours, so you have that to look forward to. And for our third and final step, I'll be tackling the New Game Plus in its entirety. What I mean by that, it's one thing to beat a New Game Plus difficulty, but it's a whole other thing to still get all the items and land all the kills and get all the secrets on that difficulty. And that's exactly gonna be my objective, like it was in Tomb Raider 1. I might not be entirely successful. I'm worried there is a single enemy that on New Game Plus difficulty of Tomb Raider 2 will not be killable. We'll see. Let me know, guys, what suggestions you have in the comment section, which enemy you think I'm referring to. But yeah, think of a gun that's most annoying to use in the entire game and you'll figure it out, okay? So, you have 2 more videos pertaining to the core Tomb Raider 2 to look forward to. Sort of the time trial with pistols only, a match made in heaven really, and then the New Game Plus. The New Game Plus video will have no commentary whatsoever. It's a bit of an experiment for me, even though I think Tomb Raiders are excellent games for commentary. For those of you who prefer no commentary, this will be your ticket, right? And it's still gonna help you no matter what difficulty you're tackling, because I'm gonna show you how to get every pickup, enemy, and secret. Okay, so that's essentially it, and once we're done with all 66 achievements for Tomb Raider 2 Remastered, I'm gonna move on to the Golden Mask expansion, which is a great expansion, made less great by some particularly annoying achievements. It's like the devs just don't want you to land all the kills, it's crazy. But I'm gonna talk more about it later, once we reach that milestone. So guys, thank you so much for sticking around. I hope you had a blast following our first playthrough of Tomb Raider 2 Remastered. In case you're not interested in doing multiple playthroughs of the game, and this is where you're gonna drop off, that's fine. Hopefully I'm gonna see you once I'll tackle the Golden Mask expansion levels and then Tomb Raider 3 Remastered, okay? We'll see if I'll be able to tackle Tomb Raider 3 still within this year, because as Christmas will be slowly approaching, I'll want to work on Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets Let's Play, kind of a Christmas special like I did last year for the Philosopher's Stone, okay? Again, game's very close to my heart, and I keep saying this over and over, I consider those Harry Potter PC games to be kind of like Tomb Raiders for kids, in a sense, and they're a lot of fun. Okay? So, that's what's next. Please have patience with me. It might take 1 or 2 weeks before I'll release the time trial video, and then again 1 or 2 weeks before I'll release the New Game Plus video. It's gonna be a lot of work, a lot of practice, a lot of recording, lots of editing, but I hope the results will be worth it. And if my Tomb Raider 1 versions of those videos are anything to go by, you guys absolutely love them. So that's that. Okay, thank you so much, and now I would actually especially like to thank my amazing patrons who made all this possible. Blengupel, Mick, Severin Drax, Marek Malets, and Katie Danger, thank you guys so much for being my Winston, and for giving some coffee to Lara to help her stay awake and fight, and to me to help me stay awake and edit this video. I would like to give big thanks to my caretaker Winston, Michael McConkey. Thank you so much for your support, and also for bandaging up Bartoli's right-hand man, Lieutenant. This way, we were able to have a rematch with him in our ballroom in this awesome epilogue level. Next, I would like to give special thanks to my veteran Winston, Andrea Pavilianiti. Thank you so much, sir, for your support, and also for stocking up Lara's cabinet with shotgun ammo, flares, and med packs. This way we were able to fight off half of Bartoli's henchmen, whereas you fought off another 2 truckloads of these guys. Unfortunately, this happened off screen. And finally, I would like to give a very, very special thanks to my one and only fine vintage Winston, Akira Foxmind. Thank you so much for your generous support, and also for locking yourself up in the freezer during the attack. I guess it doubled as a bit of a panic room for you. This way you were safe, and I didn't really want to open the freezer and endanger you to Bartoli's henchmen. Also, I would like to thank you for your generous support of my channel throughout me tackling Tomb Raider 1 and Tomb Raider 2 Remastered. You made it all possible for me in a very good time frame, and the least I can do is to give thanks in each of my videos and to do my best to keep this up. And finally, I would also like to just say thanks to everyone who has been with me on this journey so far. I love Tomb Raider 2, and I hope this has been made abundantly clear in this playthrough. You have the playthrough of Tomb Raider 3 to also look forward to in the future, and in case you'd like to help me make these videos in a more timely manner and with a better quality, feel free to check out my Patreon. You can become also a free member and just be notified whenever I release a new video. Or if you want to also directly financially support me, meaning I will be able to afford to spend more time doing these videos and I would love nothing more, in that case, there are several Winstons you can choose from, whichever one you will be, I will be there to say thank you in each of my videos. And guys, let me know via comments how you did in your own playthroughs of Tomb Raider 2. Doesn't really matter if the remastered version or the original, I want to hear it all. And now, if you'll excuse me, it's time to start all over again, and I'm gonna practice for both the time trial with pistols only and the New Game Plus videos before we'll tackle the Golden Mask expansion. So, still plenty of Tomb Raider 2 content to look forward to. Wish me good luck, and to you guys, I now wish happy raiding.